It would be hard to tell the history of Winston-Salem without including this icon on Sprague Street.
My grandfather and Joe Glenn actually patented the design.
This old shell gas station, shaped like a shell, is in the National Register of Historic Places. And Quality Oil Company President Graham Bennett gets to walk inside often.
It's like a museum.
It is.
These artifacts, where did they come from? Is this something your company saved over the years?
We have. We've saved them over the years, and I'm glad we did.
This was one of eight identical stations Graham's grandfather, Bert Bennett Sr., and his nephew, Joe Glenn Jr., built in Winston-Salem in 1930 after buying the Quality Oil Company, which was founded a year earlier. The little buildings, this is the only one still standing, created a lot of buzz, but because they were small and mechanics had to service cars outside, they quickly became obsolete. So, Quality Oil built the more traditional service stations, like the one that sits today just yards in front of the corporate headquarters on Silas Creek Parkway, and the old station in Louisville, where Graham started working when he was in the eighth grade.
My father taught me how to run out to the car, and that's when we checked the tires, the oil, washed the cars, did everything back then.
In the 1950s, with James Glenn Sr. and Graham's father, Bert Bennett Jr. at the helm, Quality Oil became one of the largest Shell oil distributors in the United States. Today, the company Graham runs consists of at least nine divisions. They include more than 50 Quality Mart convenience stores spread across North Carolina, Virginia, and Tennessee. More than 75 smaller Quality Plus and Go Gas stations, the more traditional propane, fuel oil delivery, and large tanker transportation services, and even a hospitality division, which includes eight hotels like the Hampton Inn near Haines Mall, along with the Hilton Garden Inn with its rooftop bar and kitchen, which the company built in downtown Asheville several years ago.
Why in the world would an oil company want to get into the hotel business?
We got in there by default.
Quality Oil's first hotel venture would become the Howard Johnson's off Business 85 in High Point. It was the mid-1970s, and Quality was working with a businessman who was helping it find service station properties.
But he was also in the Howard Johnson's hotel business.
Gotcha.
So he needed a financial partner, so we did one in High Point.
Today, it's the Hotel NC and has a different owner. But with the fuel shortages in the 70s, this place was a good way to diversify from gasoline and set the framework for the multifaceted company you see today, which also includes real estate. The 800-acre Brookberry Farm is one of two major residential subdivisions in Northwest Winston-Salem Quality Oil has developed. But oil is still the core business.
Given the fact that so many of the car manufacturers are building electric cars, how much does that worry you as the owner of an oil company?
Well, that's certainly on our minds. I think anybody would say in the oil business that they're not worried about fossil fuels, it would be short-sighted.
Have you considered putting charging stations at your properties?
We actually, all new locations, we pipe for charging stations
really?
Today.
What do you think, as an oil company executive, is the public's biggest misconception when it comes to gas prices?
Every area has its own competitive set with the competitors. Everybody gets different deliveries at different times. We get a price change every single day, sometimes twice a day. So it depends on when a competitor gets his fuels, or how he prices it.
But then again, volatility is a given in the oil business. That's why Graham feels diversification and the work ethic of his father are so important.
The number one thing you learned from your father is?
Respect for folks and walking in their shoes. It's the backbone of any company.